Actually, we are building on the high political relationship, which has been very much strong since a very long time, and has been strengthened more during the last year after multiple visits between China president and the Egypt president. So the Egyptian president Sisi have came to China twice, and then we had the honor and pleasure to have president of China in Egypt for like 4 days visit. And we are building on these visits to strengthen the relationship in all levels and in all angles. One of the dimensions that we are very much focusing and has a priority on the top of the agenda in Egypt is the IT and communication. So me as the one who's managing the file of communication and information technology in Egypt, we am here with the delegation of 15 people, and we are starting visiting some of the Chinese companies, multiple of them, and we are preparing to sign some of very strategic agreements with our counterparts here in China. Well, we are having multiple programs actually. So one of the things that we are building or we are planning to have the technology parks. So within the technology parks, we had multiple visits and mutual visits and meetings with TAS Park. And we are using and utilizing the expertise and experience of TAS Park to get to share their knowledge, their expertise, and even to join us in the management of the technology parks in Egypt. So we are planning to have 7 technology parks in Egypt in different province across Egypt, 3 in the upper Egypt and 3 in the Delta. We have started already by building 2, and we are expecting to finalize or to finish the first phase of the 2 technology parks by end of this year. So we are building such a very close relationship with TAS Park and other partners in China, so we can develop this aspect and we can leverage the experience of TAS Park. So this is one of the things. So we are having definitely another meetings with the with some of the big companies in the areas of cybersecurity and space security. So today we have a meeting with the top executives from China Electronic Corporation, so CETC. So we had some mutual discussions. And we agreed on how we are going to move forward in a strategic relationship together, so we can formulate some sort of an understanding on the mutual cooperation between the Ministry of Communication and Information Technology, because this is the ministry that it's handling all of the cybersecurity issues and cybersecurity center and CETC. Well, this is another one. The third one is that we are having an initiative, big initiative for electronics when it comes to design and the manufacturing or assembly of the electronics. So we are meeting with multiple Chinese companies, and we are putting in front of them the incentives that we are providing from the capacity building point of view, from the human resources point of view, and a lot of different incentives for them to attract them to come and work out of Egypt. Actually, Egypt is having a lot of competitive advantages when it comes to manufacturing and when it comes to electronics. One of them, as I've mentioned, is that the labor force and the very high and well-educated people in Egypt. Well, the a lot of incentive packages that we are providing to the investors in Egypt, plus the bilateral agreements that Egypt is having with multiple countries. So we do have a bilateral agreement with the African countries through the COMESA. We do have another agreement with the EU. This is plus the GAFTA and plus a lot of other agreements as well, the Egypt-Turkish agreement and even the World Trade Agreement with the US as well. So again, it's some sort of how we can have a mutual cooperation with China to use Egypt as a market, huge market. So it's a big market. plus use Egypt as a gateway to other countries as well, the countries in Africa and the countries in Europe. So for the Silk Road, you cannot have the Silk Road initiative executed without having the ICT as one of the main components in the Silk Road initiative. So the ICT is playing a great role just to link between the China and the rest of Africa. Egypt can play or still playing a great role in this connection or this engagement and interaction between China and the rest of Africa. So again, ICT is playing a great role. I'm sure that after this visit and with the relations that on the top level from the political point of view between the two presidents, I do believe that we are going to accelerate the Silk Road initiative and the Silk Road execution plan as much as we can. And another big news that just the day before yesterday, Egypt has been announced that it is the second economy in Africa after the economy of Nigeria. So Egypt have exceeded South Africa, and as you know that the economy of Nigeria is very much dependent or based on oil sector, but the diversity of the Egyptian economy is making it number two in Africa compared to Nigeria. Again, this is considered to be one of the very positive signs that Egypt economy is standing and Egypt economy is going in the right direction.